Good morning, children. Welcome back to my class. I told you before this lesson, that is during the culture of the Vedic period. During the time itself, I told you about the syllabus. Okay, syllabus and the how many portions or subtopic has been reduced. Told you. So I told you. While I take a new lesson during that time also, I'll be informing you about the reduced portions. Okay, children. So according to that, the first lesson was the Christianity and Islam. Christianity and Islam. That lesson has been completely reduced from your syllabus. I've already given you the notes for that lesson. Okay, children. You make a point that you don't read that lesson, Christianity and Islam. If you return the notes, it can be there only, but don't read that lesson for your exam. That is not included in your portions. Okay, and same thing I told you in the Vedic civilization. In that also I told you some of the things which is not there. Okay, now next it is about the rise of new religion. In that lesson also, teachings of Buddha and the teachings of Mahavira is being deleted from your syllabus. Understood, children? That is the teachings of Buddha and Mahavira. Okay, and only that is reduced from your syllabus. Other than that, it is there. Why did the new religion emerge? Then life of Buddha, then life of Mahavira, then Mahajanapadas, Republics. These are all included in your syllabus. Okay, children? Alright. Okay, rise of new religion. New religion, as I told you in the beginning, Christianity and Islam is also a major religion of the world. Okay, one among them, again it is here, that is Christianity and Islam. I've already explained to you. Okay, but now here it is about the Buddhism and Jainism. Why did the new religion emerge? What is the need for the new religion? Why the new religion should come? Okay, the primary cause, the very important cause for the rise of the new religion is the religion unrest in India. Religion unrest in India in the 6th century BC. Understood? Religion unrest in India during the 6th century BC. And whatever the religion unrest was there, then the complex rituals and sacrifice was not acceptable by the common people. That's because people already believed that through these yajnas only they can attain salvation or moksha. But whatever rituals they are doing, that is very expensive. It is very costly. Okay, so milk and ghee were offered as havisu and burnt in the fire, which resulted in the shortage of food. Okay, these are all very costly rituals that was performed by the Brahmanas. Okay, then now by then it is about the mantras confused the common people. Whatever the mantras the Brahmanas were reciting, that was not understandable by the common people. Okay, next it is society was based on Varna system. As you all know, that is Indian society was divided into the Varna system. What are the Varna system? That is the Brahmanas, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas and the Shudras. Here Brahmanas, they were placed in the higher position in the society. Okay, they were the people who were doing all the religious rituals. They were the people who were involved in the kingdom. They were the Brahmanas, were the people who assisted the king. They were performing all the yagas and the yajnas. Okay, they were placed in the higher position in the society. Next it is the Kshatriya. that is sustaining by paying tax. The Kshatriyas, they will sustain. They will not pay the tax to the government or for the taxing. They will sustain from paying the tax. Okay. Then next it is the Vaishyas. These people are the third in the Varna system. That is, they businessmen included businessmen. Then animal husbandry, trade. These they were involved in such things. Okay, so all these three people were they were leading a susceptible life. But whereas the Shudras, they were the labor class. They were the slaves. They were ill-treated. They have to pay the tax to the government. Okay, they have to pay the tax to the king, whatever it is. Understood? That too, they were the workers. Their life was miserable. Understood? So this Varna system was existed during this time. Okay, so that is the reason why. Okay, so many religious factors, social factors, economical factors. Due to the Varna system, social integration set in. This led to social discrimination. The priestly class, that is the Brahmanas. Brahmanas had mainly more luxuries. Meanwhile, the Kshatriyas started becoming powerful. Then, as a result, republics emerged. The Kshatriya became the reason for the emergence of the new religion. Okay? That were against the Brahmanas. Understood? And so, this was all the main reasons. And moreover, the Vedas which were written, they were all written in the Sanskrit language. The Vedas were written in the Sanskrit language, and that one was not understandable by the common people. Okay? It was not understood by the common people. Common people were not able to understand whatever the mantras, whatever the rituals was written. So it was not the easy job for them to understand. So that is why this all became complex. The complex rituals became complex. It was so expensive. Mantras confused the common people, and society was based on Varnas. So these are all the reasons why there was a reason for the new religions. That is Jainism and Buddhism. Okay? Jainism and Buddhism came into existence. Okay? First I will talk about Buddhism. Okay? Buddhism. The religion Buddhism was founded by Buddha. It was established about 2500 years ago, this Buddhism was established by Gautama Buddha. Gautama Buddha, he was born in Lumbini near Kapilavastu of Nepal. Okay? His childhood name was Siddhartha. When he was a boy, when he was a baby, at this small age, his name was Siddhartha. Okay, his father was Shuddhodana and the head of the Shakya Republic. He was the head of the Shakya Republic. Okay, his mother was Maya Devi. The Siddhartha's father was Shuddhodana and mother was Maya Devi, and his wife was Yashodhara, and he had a son by name Rahul. Okay, he had a son by name Rahul. It is said that the story tells that is a sage named Asta. He said that Siddhartha would be the king of the world after seeing him as an infant. When he saw him as an infant, the saint said that this baby will be a great king. But also he said, he also predicted that he would be a sage. He would be the sage who will get rid of the misery of the world. On hearing the words of the sage, okay, on hearing the words of the sage, that is Shuddhodana, he got very worried. He wanted his son to be a king. Rather, he doesn't want his son to be a sage or a sannyasi. Okay, so what he did? He protected his son in the palace. He kept him away from the worldly things. He didn't allow him to go out of the palace. But unfortunately, what happened? Once while roaming in the city, there this Siddhartha, he saw an old man. And secondly, he saw a deceased man. And thirdly, he saw a funeral procession, a dead body. Okay? All seeing that, all the four scenes made him to renounce the worldly things. Okay? This completely changed his mind. He came to know why the people are suffering so much. And after seeing all these incidents, he was not having his mind to be in the palace. Okay, as because in this childhood itself, his mind was spiritually. He was put up his mind in a spiritual way rather than the worldly ways. Understood, children? So, what happened? He, one night, Siddhartha, he left his family and palace without informing anyone. He left the palace and went out of the palace. He sought guidance from many sages on the way how to remove the misery from the people. He got the guidelines, okay? But he did not find the... Finally, what happened? He sat under a peepal tree. Peepal tree in Gaya of Bihar and meditated for many days. There he meditated upon God. Why this sorrow? Why this misery? Why this pain among the people? Why the differentiate among the people? Okay? And finally, he became enlightened there. His mind became enlightened there and he became Buddha. Understood? He sat under a peepal tree and he began to meditate and there he got the enlightenment and there only he was became a Buddha. Buddha means, what I mean by Buddha? Buddha means one who knows. Buddha means one who knows. Okay? This place is known as Bodh Gaya. What is the place called? The place is called as Bodh Gaya. Understood, children? So, Buddha preached his thoughts. What he thought? He preached his thought in five disciples at Sarnath near Varanasi of present Uttar Pradesh for the first time. First time where he preached. That one only is called as Dharma Chakra Parivartana. What it is called as? Dharma Chakra Parivartana. Okay? Later, he travelled around Bihar and other places and about 40 years and preached his thoughts. Slowly, the fame of Buddha spread all over the world. So, Buddha, he passed away at Kushinagar of Bihar. His death. He died in the place called Kushinagar of Bihar. Okay, children, that is all about the life of Buddha. But teachings of Buddha is not there in your topic. Okay, next it is about the Mahavira, life of Mahavira. Mahavira is the 24th Tirthankara. What is Tirthankara? Tirthankara is a savior, a spiritual teacher of the Dharma. Okay? The enlightened person. Tirthankara means the enlightened person or the savior or the spiritual teacher of the Dharma. So he was the 24th Tirthankara. He was born in 2500 years ago. He was born at Kundala Grama near Vaishali. His earlier name was Vardhamana. What was the earlier name of Buddha? Siddhartha. Siddhartha was the earlier name of Buddha. Whereas this Mahavira's name was Vardhamana, was his earliest name. Vardhamana's father was Siddhartha, a rich Kshatriya on the edge of the Kunda Grama. As you all know, this Buddha as well as Mahavira both were from the Kshatriya. They were the Kshatriya. They were the ruling class people. They were born in the ruling class people, both Buddha and Mahavira. Understood? So, Vardhamana left his home in search of enlightenment. He spent some of his Digambara Muni. Later, he 12 years. Jinnah means, what do you mean by Jinnah? Jinnah means one who conquer. Okay, Mahavira preached to people from all classes. Jinnah means one who has conquered attachment of moha. Okay, next it is, he left his body at Pavapuri in present Bihar. He left his body in Pavapuri in West Bihar. Whereas this Buddha, he was passed in Kushinagar of Bihar. Okay, so next it is the teachings of Mahavira that is not there in your syllabus. Next it is Mahajanapadas. What do you mean by Mahajanapadas? So let us go back to 2500 years in time. That was the time when Buddha lived, 2500 years back. During the time Buddha and Mahavira came into existence, they were 16 kingdoms, big and small, in Sindhu Ganga plain. These kingdoms are called as Mahajanapadas. They were 16 small and big kingdoms. These 16 kingdoms were called as the Mahajanapadas. Among them, Magadha, Kosala and Vatsa were famous Mahajanapadas. They were ruled by the kings. Next it is the Republic. In the same period, during the Buddha and Mahavira existed, during the same period only, many states had representative governments. They were called republics. Representative governments, they were called as the republics. The most important among them was the Vajji. What was that? That was Vajji. It was a union of many republics, many union of many republics, many states. Okay? So Vaishali city of Bihar was its capital. Vaishali, that was the capital of this Vajji. Next, Vajji had a sabha consisting of elder and younger members taking care of administration. Okay, so all matters related to the union were discussed at the sabha meeting. That is what the lesson it is. Why the need for the new religion came? What was the reason for the rise of new religion? What are the reasons I explained to you? Go through that. Okay, what do you mean by renunciation? Renunciation means what? Buddha also renounced the worldly pleasure, whereas Mahavira also renounced the worldly pleasure. What do you mean by renunciation? Leaving away all the worldly pleasure. Okay? Leaving all the worldly aspiration. That is only renunciation. What do you mean by Shvetambara? Shvetambara, that is the two religions, two sects of Mahavira. Okay, Mahavira, this is the Shvetambara and Digambara. Shvetambara is the people, those who are wearing white clothes. Whereas Digambara, these people were the people, no clothes were worn by them. Okay, they were naked. These people are called as Digambara. Understood? So there is no teachings about Buddha and Mahavira. I'll let us stop here. I'll send you the notes for this particular portion. You copy the notes and send the notes to me. Alright, children? Okay, thank you.